हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर मोहम्मद अहमद, आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू द 36th लेक्चर ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स 2. स्टूडेंट्स, इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड फ्यू प्रॉब्लम्स रिलेटेड टू बीटा एंड गामा फंक्शन. सो दैट वी विल कंटिन्यू टुडे आल्सो वी आर गोइंग टू सी फ्यू प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन बीटा एंड गामा फंक्शन. सो बेसिकली इन लास्ट क्लास वी हैव सीन प्रॉब्लम्स रिलेटेड टू बीटा फंक्शन. Now in today's class we will be focusing on problems related to gamma function. Hope you remember the basic definitions of beta and gamma function. Now today the first problem is evaluate integral 0 to infinite x power 6 e power minus 2x dx, right? If the limits are from 0 to 1, then we have to go for using the definition of beta function. But if the limits are from 0 to infinite, so for this type of problems we will be using gamma function. If you remember the definition of gamma function, so gamma n is defined as integral 0 to infinite e power minus x power n minus 1 dx. This is the basic definition of gamma function. You see that in the given question also integral limits are from 0 to infinite and x power 6. So x power 6 can be written in the form of x power n minus 1, that is x power 7 minus 1. But here you observe that e power minus x is there in the definition, and in the given question e power minus 2x is there. So we have to make some substitution here to get a single variable, right? Instead of 2x we need a variable here. So that is why we'll take a substitution. Put 2x equals to some other variable y, then what will happen? 2dx, derivative is 2 into dx equals to dy. This implies dx equals to dy by 2, right? So then what will happen? Now let us consider the given question. Integral 0 to infinite x power 6 e power minus 2x dx, right? This is equal to, see, because it's a direct substitution, as x goes to 0, lower limit, I'm talking about the lower limit, as x goes to 0 y will also go to 0, and for upper limit as x goes to infinite y will also go to infinite. Therefore the limits will be from 0 to infinite. Limits are not going to change because this substitution is a direct substitution, right? Then x power 6 is there. What will be the value of x from this? X will be y by 2. So y by 2 whole power 6 e power minus 2x. E power minus 2x is y, right? And dx is dy by 2. Just you take here 2 power 6 and here 2 power 1 common, then what will happen? 2 power 6 and 2 power 1 is 2 power 7. So 1 by 2 power 7, limits will be, integral limits will be from 0 to infinite e power minus y and y power 6 dx, sorry dy, right? Further this can be simplified as 1 by 2 power 7 integral 0 to infinite e power minus y. See, what I'm going to do here is integral 0 to infinite e power minus y power 6 is there, no? That I'm comparing with the definition, right? See, e power minus some variable power 6, but we need here variable power n minus 1 should be there. So this 6 can be written as 7 minus 1, so it will be y power 7 minus 1 into dy, right? Now this can be written as 1 by 2 power 7. See, You apply this definition here, what will happen? Gamma 7, we will get gamma n is gamma 7. Now what is gamma 7? We know that gamma n is n minus 1 factorial. Gamma n is n minus 1 factorial if n is integer, right? If n is integer, then gamma n is n minus 1 factorial. Here we are having gamma 7, where 7 is an integer. So 7 minus 1 factorial, which is nothing but 6 factorial. So 6 factorial by 2 power 7. This is the required answer. If you want to further simplify this, you can simplify. If we simplify, I'm not doing all the simplifications here, but when we simplify, we are going to get it to be 45/8, I guess. Even if you are not getting, you can check what we are exactly getting here, right? 6 factorial by 2 power 7, you simplify, you will get the answer, right? So this is the procedure for solving problems in which limits will be from 0 to infinite, right? If the limits are from 0 to infinite, then we have to use gamma function, right? So instead of this, suppose if other problems are also given, so what kind of other problems may be given? We'll consider few more examples. I'm not going to solve, just I'll give the brief hint, right? What you have to do. Just I'll explain that only. Suppose the question E is given like this: evaluate integral 0 to infinite e power minus 4x x power 3/2 dx. Or the question may be given as integral 0 to infinite e power minus root x dx. Or the question may be given as integral 0 to infinite root x e power minus x square dx. Or the next question may be given as integral 0 to infinite x square e power minus x square dx. So idea is same in all these questions. What we have to do? We need to apply the basic definition of gamma function, and the gamma function definition is gamma n equal to integral 0 to infinite e power minus x x power n minus 1 dx. This is the basic definition of gamma function, right? We need to get minus x power in exponential. Whatever is there in exponential, that should be replaced with minus of some variable. You consider this question here, minus 4x is there, right? But we need minus x only or minus y only. So we have to take a substitution here, put 4x equals to y. Then remaining procedure, everything is same as the previous problem. Whatever I have solved here, you consider the same procedure for this problem also, right? Then the next problem, integral 0 to infinite e power minus root x dx. See, here we need e power minus x only, but we are having e power minus root x. So we have to take a substitution here, root x equals to y. Then remaining procedure is same. Just I'm giving the hint on the substitution, right? I'm giving you the hint on substitution. According to that substitution, the remaining procedure you have to follow, right? Next, for this type of question, integral 0 to infinite root x e power minus x square dx is there. We need here x only, but we are having x square. So take a substitution as put x square equals to y. For this next question also, you need to take put x square equals to y. Then the remaining procedure you have to follow as the previous problem, right? So these kind of questions may be asked based on the basic definition of gamma function, right? Now we'll see problems related to beta function. Okay, the next question is, evaluate integral 0 to π/2 square root of cot theta d theta, right? So in which function we are having the limits as 0 to π/2? See, in gamma function, the limits are from 0 to infinite, always 0 to infinite only. But in beta function, we are having the limits as 0 to 1 and 0 to π/2. So we are going to use the definition of beta function now. So let us see how we are going to use the definition of beta function to solve this problem, right? Already we know one relation, which is something like this: beta of m comma n equals to 1/2 integral 0 to π/2 sine power 2m minus 1 theta and cos power 2n minus 1 theta d theta, right? This definition we have to use here because the limits are from 0 to π/2. So the given integral can be written as integral 0 to π/2 square root of cot theta. This can be written as integral 0 to π/2 square root of cot theta. Can be written as, see, tan theta is sin by cos, cot is cos by sin, so cos theta by sin theta d theta. Now further this can be written as integral 0 to π/2 cos power you see that root cos theta, root is nothing but, square root is nothing but power 1 by 2. So power 1 by 2 theta, and sine power, this 1 by 2 if you bring up, it will become minus 1 by 2. So minus 1 by 2 theta d theta, right? So we got the integral 0 to pi by 2 root cot theta d theta as integral 0 to pi by 2 cos power 1 by 2 theta and sine power minus 1 by 2 theta d theta, right? Now you consider this as some equation 1. So from this relation I can write from properties of beta function. From properties of beta function, I can write 2 into this 2 I am taking to left hand side. So 2 into, sorry, actually this formula I have written wrong. It is 2, not 1 by 2. So when you take this 2 to left hand side, it will become 1 by 2, right? It will become 1 by 2 beta of m comma n equals to integral 0 to pi by 2 sine power 2m minus 1 theta and cos power 2n minus 1 theta d theta. This I am writing from the properties of beta function. Now you compare this right hand side with this. So here sine power minus 1 by 2 is there, here sine power 2m minus 1 is there. So what we are doing is put 2m minus 1 equals to sine power minus 1 by 2 and 2n minus 1 equals to cos power 1 by 2. Now find the value of m from this. 2m equals to minus 1 by 2 plus 1, which is 2. When you take the LCM here, you will get 2 minus 1, or 1 minus half is half. So m equals to 1 by 4 we will get, right? And here 2n equals to 1 by 2 plus 1, which is 3 by 2. So n equals to 3 by 4, right? 3 by 4, m equals to 1 by 4, n equals to 3 by 4. So from this, what we can do here, 1 by 2 beta of what is m now? M is 1 by 4, n is 3 by 4, which is equal to integral 0 to pi by 2 sine power 2m minus 1, I am taking as minus half. So minus half theta cos power 2n minus 1 I am taking as 1 by 2 theta d theta. Consider this as equation 2. Now from equation 1 and equation 2, right hand sides are same. So therefore what will happen? Therefore what will be the left hand side? Left hand side is integral 0 to pi by 2 root cot theta d theta. This will be equal to 1 by 2 into beta of 1 by 4 comma 3 by 4, right? 1 by 2 into, because these two right hand sides are same, I can equate these two. That is what I am doing here. 1 by 2 beta of 1 by 4 comma 3 by 4. Further, from the relation of beta and gamma function, beta of 1 by 4 comma 3 by 4 is nothing but gamma 1 by 4 gamma 3 by 4 by gamma 1 by 4 plus 3 by 4. Further simplify this. What will happen? 1 by 2 into gamma 1 by 4, right? And this gamma 1 by 4 plus 3 by 4, what will happen in the denominator? Let us see. 3 plus 1, 4 by 4 is 1. So gamma 1 value, denominator will become 1. Now in the numerator, gamma 1 by 4 is remaining. Here gamma 3 by 4 is remaining. Now this gamma 3 by 4 can be written as gamma 1 minus 1 by 4. Right, can I write 3 by 4 as 1 minus 1 by 4? 4 minus 1 is 3 by 4. Yes, I can write. Then we can use this formula also. Gamma n into gamma 1 minus n. We have derived this relation in a theorem. Gamma n into gamma 1 minus n is pi by sine n pi. This relation I will use here. So what will happen here when I use that relation? 1 by 2 into, I will get pi by, what? See, n into gamma n into gamma 1 minus n. What is n here? 1 by 4. So I will get sine n. n is 1 by 4. So pi by 4, which is equal to 1 by 2 pi by sine pi by 4 value. Sine pi by 4 value is 1 by root 2. Sine 45, 1 by root 2. Then what will happen? So root 2 by 2 into pi, root into pi, which is equal to pi by root 2. So final answer is pi by root 2. So what we have done? We have evaluated the value of integral 0 to pi by 2 square root of cot theta d theta. We have used this formula because in this property of beta function, limits will be from 0 to pi by 2, right? Limits will be from 0 to pi by 2. So 0 to pi by 2 root cot theta d theta can be written as cos by sine. Then we will get this cos power 1 by 2 sine power minus 1 by 2 d theta. From this property of beta function, we are having this. I'll try to compare these two. In the place of 2m minus 1, I'll put 1 by 2. In place of 2n minus 1, I'll put minus 1 by 2. Right? Then I'll get this relation. When I evaluated the values of m and n, I got it to be 1 by 4 and 3 by 4. That I will substitute here. Then from these two equations, this one and this one, I can write this integral equal to 1 by 2 beta of 1 by 4 comma 3 by 4. By using the relation between beta and gamma function, I can write this. Further, I have used one more relation called gamma n into gamma 1 minus n, which is pi by sine n pi. I have used that to get the answer to be pi by root 2, right? So in this type, what other questions may be asked? So let us see a few more questions which are similar to this, where we have to use the definition of beta function. So next question may be like this. Here also I am not going to solve completely, just I will give you the hint. Right, the question will be integral 0 to pi by 2 sine power 5 theta and cos power 7 by 2 theta d theta, or else a question may be like integral 0 to pi by 2 sine power 7 theta d theta. Right? How we are going to solve this? See, we know the definition beta of m comma n equals to integral 2 into integral 0 to pi by 2. We can even write this 2 to left hand side. So we will get 1 by 2 0 to pi by 2 sine power 2m minus 1 theta and cos power 2n minus 1 theta d theta. So compare this with the given equation. Right, compare this formula, this property with the given equation. Then in place of 2m minus 1, so put 2m minus 1 equals to 5 and 2n minus 1 equals to 7 by 2. Find the values of m and n from this. What will be m and what will be n? Plug these two in this and use the relation between beta and gamma function. You will get the answer as I have done in the previous problem. Right, the same thing here also. See, this question can be written as 0 to pi by 2. I can write this as sine power 7 theta. Cos is not there, no? That can be written as cos power 0 theta. Cos power 0 is nothing but 1. Right? I can write like this. Again, you compare this with 2m minus 1 and compare this with 2n minus 1. Find the values of m and n. Then use again this relation. Use this relation. Right, you will get the answer. Right, so this is these are the two types of problems which may be asked from this. You need to practice all this. Right, so I'm showing you the possibilities, different possibilities I'm showing you. You need to practice this. Right, next we'll see other type of problems from beta and gamma function. Okay, the next question is, using beta and gamma functions, evaluate the integral minus 1 to 1, 1 minus x square whole power n dx, where n is positive integer. Using beta and gamma functions, we have to evaluate this integral, right? So I'll consider the given integral as, let I equals to, I'm denoting the integral by I, integral minus 1 to 1, 1 minus x square dx, right? This is just the notation. So whenever in this problem I write I, means you have to understand that integral minus 1 to 1, 1 minus x square dx, or the given integral, 1 minus x square, here whole power n is there, right? Now this can be written as integral minus 1 to 1. So given integral can be written as, it is in the form of a square minus b square. 1 minus x square is in the form of a square minus b square. Now this can be written as 1 minus 1 plus x into 1 minus x, right, whole power n dx, right? I can write like this, a minus b, a square minus b square is nothing but a plus b into a minus b, that I have done here. Now instead of writing power to the complete whole term, I can divide these powers as here power n and here also power n, then I can remove this, right? So I can write the given integral as, just I'm separating these terms, right? The given integral will become like this. Then you see, I know the basic definition of beta function. Beta of m comma n equals to integral 0 to 1 x power m minus 1 and 1 minus x whole power n minus 1 dx, right? If you compare the given terms with this, here 1 minus x is there, here also 1 minus x is there, fine. Here x is there, here I am having 1 plus x. So I need to change this 1 plus x. I need to change this 1 plus x to some other term. So I'll take a substitution here. Put 1 plus x equals to some other substitution. That substitution may be 2t, right? Why I'm taking these two? Directly, actually, I'm supposed to take only one variable like y or t or z like that. But why I'm taking these two, you will understand later. I'm taking 2t. Then what will happen? Now you just differentiate this. What will happen? Dx equals to derivative of 1 is 0, derivative of x is dx equals to 2 into derivative of t is dt, right? Then what will happen with limits? Or else I have computed this term, 1 plus x is 2t. Now I need 1 minus x also. Now from this substitution, what will happen with 1 minus x? Let us compute that, which is equal to 1 minus, what is x? X is from this relation, x is 2t minus 1. You take this 1 to this side, so 2t minus 1, 2t minus 1, which is equal to 1 minus 2t minus minus, and this minus will become plus 1. So this is equal to 2 minus 2t, which is equal to 2 into, what will remain here, 2 into 1 minus t will remain, 1 minus t, right? So 1 minus x can be replaced with 2 into 1 minus t, and 1 plus x should be replaced with 2t. Then what will happen with limits? We need to bother about limits also here. So lower limit is minus 1, upper limit is 1. As x goes to minus 1 and as x goes to 1, for the lower limit, as x goes to minus 1, what will happen with t? Right, as x goes to minus 1, this will become minus 1, this x will become minus 1, 1 minus 1 will become 0, then t will become 0. So as x goes to minus 1, t goes to 0. Now upper limit, as x goes to 1, here 1, so 1 plus 1 will be 2, so t equals to 2 by 2, which is 1. So as x goes to 1, t will also go to 1. Therefore finally what will happen, the given integral I will become integral, see, minus 1 to 1 will become 0 to 1, right? 0 to 1. Then 1 plus x can be replaced with 2t, so 2t whole power n, then 1 minus x, so 1 minus x will become 2 into 1 minus t, so 2 into 1 minus t whole power n into dx. What is dx? Dx can be replaced with 2 into dt. So now we have to simplify this integral, then we will get the required value, right? This is equal to, see, 2 power n is here, in this term 2 power n is there, in this term also 2 power n is there, so 2 power 2n, we will get 2 power n plus n, 2 power 2n plus 2 power 1 will be there. So finally we will get 2 power 2n plus 1, then remaining integral 0 to 1 टी पावर एन वन माइनस टी पावर एन डी टी. नाउ दिस कैन बी रिटन एज इंटीग्रल 0 to 1. एक्चुअली वी नीड दिस फॉर्म, वी नीड इंटीग्रल 0 to 1 एक्स पावर एम माइनस वन एंड 1 - x होल पावर एन माइनस वन. सो दिस कैन बी रिटन एज टी पावर एन प्लस वन माइनस वन, राइट. दिस प्लस वन एंड माइनस वन विल गेट कैंसल, फाइनली विल गेट एन ओनली एंड 1 - t होल पावर एन प्लस वन माइनस वन इंटू डी टी, राइट. सो फाइनली वॉट विल गेट 2 पावर 2n प्लस 1 इंटीग्रल 0 to 1. We don't need to write integral now. Directly we can use the definition of beta function. According to this, it will be, if m is here, then we will get m here also. If n is here, we'll get n here. Then, but here we are having n plus 1 here and n plus 1 here. So this will be beta of n plus 1 comma n plus 1. So finally, 2 power 2n plus 1. Now use the relation between beta and gamma. Right, if we use the relation between beta and gamma, so gamma n plus 1, we will get gamma n plus 1 again into gamma n plus 1 divided with gamma n plus 1 plus n plus 1. This I am using, here I am using the relation between beta and gamma function, which is equal to 2 power 2n plus 1. Now what is gamma n plus 1, where n is an integer, so gamma n plus 1 is n factorial. Here we will get 1 n factorial, here also we will get 1 more n factorial. So n factorial whole square, this is divided with, here what we will get, 2n plus 2, gamma 2n plus 2. So finally 2n plus 1 n factorial whole square divided with this gamma 2n plus 2 can be written as 2n plus 1 factorial. Right, actually n gamma n can be written as, see, gamma n can be written as n minus 1 factorial. 1 has to be reduced, right. This is the basic formula, and 1 has to be reduced. That is what I am doing here. Here I am reducing 1, then I will get n factorial. Here I am reducing 1, then I will get 2n plus 2 minus 1. So 2n plus 1 factorial. So this will be the final and required answer, which is 2 power 2n plus 1 n factorial whole square by 2n plus 1 factorial, right. So this type of problems will be asked in the examination. This is a important problem. Now we'll see the last problem of today's class, then we'll wind up. Okay, the last question is, evaluate beta of 2.5 comma 1.5, right. So sometimes it will happen that the question will be given, beta terms will be given in the decimal form. Now this terms can be written as beta of 2.5 comma 1.5. this can be written as beta of 2.5 can be written as 5 by 2, and 1.5 can be written as 3 by 2. 2.5 is actually the half of 5 and 1.5 is half of 3. So 5 by 2 comma 3 by 2. Now use the relation between beta and gamma function, that is gamma m gamma n by gamma m plus n. So according to that, it will be gamma 5 by 2 gamma 3 by 2 by gamma 5 by 2 plus 3 by 2. So which is equal to, what will be gamma n, right? Gamma n is, see, n is not an integer here. If n is an integer, gamma n is n minus 1 factorial. If n is not an integer, then gamma n is n minus 1 into gamma n minus 1. If n is not an integer, this will be the definition of gamma function. Gamma n can be replaced with n minus 1 into gamma n minus 1 if n is not an integer. If n is an integer, then gamma n equals to n minus 1 factorial we have to write. But here you see that 5 by 2 is not an integer, 3 by 2 is not an integer, then we have to use this definition. So this is equal to gamma 5 by 2. So what will happen, 5 by 2 minus 1 into gamma 5 by 2 minus 1. So I'll evaluate this complete thing. 5 by 2, gamma 5 by 2 is nothing but 5 by 2 minus 1 into gamma 5 by 2 minus 1, which is equal to 3 by 2 into gamma 3 by 2. Again, for gamma 3 by 2, you apply the same definition. So what we'll get, 3 by 2 into 1 by 2 gamma 1 by 2. which is equal to 3 by 2 into 1 by 2 into gamma 1 by 2 value is root pi by 2. This is well established relation that gamma 1 by 2 value is root pi by 2. So for gamma 5 by 2, we can write 3 by 2 into 1 by 2 into root pi. This is for gamma 5 by 2. The same way for gamma 3 by 2, what will happen? See, gamma 3 by 2 equals to 3 by 2 minus 1 into gamma 3 by 2 minus 1. 3 by 2 minus 1 is nothing but 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 into gamma 1 by 2. Gamma 1 by 2 value is root pi. So this is divided with here 5 by 2 plus 3 by 2 is there. No, when we take the LCM, we'll get 5 plus 3 by 2. 5 plus 3 is 8 by 2 is 4. So gamma 4. Gamma 4, 4 is an integer, right? Gamma 4, 4 is an integer. Then we'll get 3 factorial here. 4 minus 1 factorial, which is 3 factorial, right? 3 factorial. This is equal to, simplify in the numerator, 3 by, see, 2 into 2 into 2. 2 to the 4 to the 8, right? 8. Root pi into root pi is pi. This is divided with 3 into 2 is 6, right? So finally, what we'll get? So 3 by this 8 and 6 will be multiplied, we'll get 48. So 3 by 48 into pi is the required answer for this type of questions, right? When we are given beta of 2.5 comma 1.5, we try to reduce this into fractions, 5 by 2 and 3 by 2, then use relation between beta and gamma function, then you will get like this. Finally, you use the definition of gamma function, that is gamma n equals to n minus 1 factorial, or gamma n equals to n minus 1 into gamma n minus 1 if n is not an integer in this case, if n is an integer in this case, right? Then finally, 3 by 48 into pi is the answer, right? So in the last class and today's class, we have discussed various types of problems related to beta and gamma function. So you can practice more and more problems to get perfection for using the definition of beta and gamma function, right? In next class, we will discuss what is error function, right? And we'll see few properties and problems related to error function. I'm going to end today's session here. See you in the next class. Thank you.